Hello and welcome to this next class on HVDC and fax transmission. In the earlier classes, we have seen the comparison of HVDC and AC transmission system. Ranges where HVDC is more useful as compared to AC. We have also seen some of the fundamentals of the power electronic switches. Namely, the turn on device, turn off device, etc. Now we will begin with the actual construction of a HVDC converter station. As you are aware, when you transmit power over a long distance using HVDC, you have to do using converters. So HVDC transmission will happen in a very simple manner. You will have this AC side, right? This AC side will provide you with AC power. Then you have to convert this AC power into DC power and then transmit it over the transmission system. It can be underground cable or it can be a wire. And whenever this transmission reaches the other side, you will have to convert it back to AC. So for doing this conversion, we need a converter station. In fact, the converter station costs the most in the HVDC system. The transmission lines themselves don't cost very much, but the converter stations have a majority of cost. Okay. So what are the components of the converter stations? Let us see them quickly. So here in this diagram, you can see these numbered systems are shown. So as of now, we will quick item and later on we will delve into the details of each of these. So wherever one is written, that is a 12 pulse converter. So these two things which are shown here, this is a 12 pulse converter. Now what is a 12 pulse converter? Okay, this will be studied in detail later on. We also have a 24 pulse converter. We have a 48 pulse converter nowadays. All these things are possible. So we'll see them slowly. Okay, these are basically the power electronic switches or converters which convert AC into DC. Then transformer. Okay, so these are the transformers. So star delta, star on one AC side, delta on the other side. It can be of different configurations like star star here. So why the star star and star delta? This is to get the 12 pulse operation. So again, I'll tell you why these transformers, two transformers are used in star star and star delta. Okay, because we need a 12 pulse operation. So we'll see how this is done. So these are the transformers. Then we have something called as smoothing reactor. So smoothing reactors are basically kept immediately after the converters when it is converted to DC. Okay. And you can see all these things which are shown here are in pairs. So if there is a converter here, one, another one. If there is a smoothing reactor here, three, another smoothing reactor here is three. These are in pairs because we are working on two lines or two poles. So this is pole one, this is pole two. So then since this is a two pole operation, we are working like this. Okay. Then the next components are the DC filters. Okay. Now, what are these DC filters? So whatever conversion you have done from AC to DC, it is not always ripple free. There are ripples in that. So ideal DC you will expect like this constant line with respect to time. If this is time, okay, and if this is the voltage or current, then you will see this is the, but practically you will have lines like this, okay, which are unidirectional but which have ripples. Solve this ripple issue, we need the DC filters. Okay. Then 5 and 6, tuned AC filters and high pass AC filters. So these AC filters are on the AC side, they are not on the DC side. Okay. So everything which is on the left side of the converter is the AC system, and everything which is on the right side of the converter is the DC system. So this you have to understand very clearly. Okay. So anything, this is the converter, 1, 1, this is the converter. So anything which is on the left side of this converter is the AC system, and anything which is on the right of this system is the DC system. Okay, so here since this belongs to the AC, so in AC also we need the filters to filter out unwanted signals of high frequency. Okay, so the filters are absolutely essential, because when we connect these converters, they draw a non-sinusoidal current, and because of that there are frequencies, undesirable frequencies, which come into the system, which is known as the harmonic. So to avoid these harmonics, we have to use the high pass filters. So high pass filters, okay, which will be higher frequencies will be grounded by this 6 number high pass filter, and these are tuned filters which will be tuned to a particular set of harmonics to avoid any further damage. Okay, so this is in brief the HVDC converter station. So what are the major components of HVDC converter station? You have the AC filter, we have a transformer, okay, then we have the converter. Of course, the converter is controlled by the control system. We have the smoothing reactor and DC filters, and then it is given to the transmission cable. So I hope that you have understood the basic layout of the HVDC converter station. So let us now see further. This is another diagram which essentially represents the above diagram only. I have just taken it from another source, it is more clear. So you have the AC bus here, then we have the circuit breakers, then the transformers, then the converters, smoothing reactor, filters, okay, and exactly same thing is repeated here. Then it will be transmitted over the transmission line. So this is the DC line, this much DC line, DC line. After the DC line reaches the other end, let us say that this distance is 500 kilometer. So after the DC line travels 500 km, reaches the other end, then again we'll have the DC filter, smoothing reactor, converter, transformer, and it will be connected to the AC bus, right? And here reactive power source is shown on both the sides. Reactive power source. Reactive power source is required because we are using these converters, they draw a lot of reactive power. And AC filters will be used to filter out the unnecessary harmonics, okay? So the components are converters, smoothing reactors, harmonic filters, reactive power supplies, electrodes. Electrodes will be required when you ground, because on both these sides these connections will be grounded, okay? So these connections have to be grounded, and these are grounded through electrodes. So electrodes will be required, and of course the circuit breaker, AC circuit breakers. Now a quick overview of the devices like converters. So converters, they perform AC to DC and DC to AC conversion. They consist of valve, bridges and transformers. Okay, now what are these valves? We'll see later on. Valve is just like your water valve. If you open the valve, water will flow. If you close the valve, water cannot flow. Similarly, we can create a valve which will allow the electricity to flow or not flow. That is what valve is. And if we use number of valves together, it is called as a valve bridge. Okay, it consists of high voltage valves which are connected in a 6 pulse or 12 pulse arrangement. So again and again this name is coming up, 6 pulse, 12 pulse, 6 pulse, 12 pulse. So I'll tell you what is this slightly later. The transformers are ungrounded such that the DC system will be able to establish its own reference to ground. Then smoothing reactors. Smoothing reactors are high value reactors with inductance very high. They have a large inductance. It may be as large as 1 Henry in series with each pole. Each pole means each converter. So output of the converter. So this is a smoothing reactor. So this on the upper pole and this is on the lower pole. These values can be as high as 1 Henry. Okay. Why they are used? Because they decrease harmonics in voltages and currents in DC lines. They prevent commutation failure in inverters. So what is this commutation failure? So when we use the thyristors or SCRs, we have to stop the switch. We have to turn off the switch. Turning off the switch is also called as commutation. Okay. So just like your fan switch, when you turn on the fan switch, you say that you are firing the switch. And when you turn off the switch, you call that you are commutating the switch. So this commutation in these converters is automatic, or it is based on control system. But sometimes due to some reason, there can be a commutation failure. And if you want to shut out the fan and if you cannot, then there can be problems. Similarly, if you want to shut out the DC converter and if you cannot, there will be problems. So this is commutation failure is a major problem which can be prevented by using the smoothing reactor. It also prevents current from being discontinuous for light loads. So if the load is very light, if the current is very low, then the load is light, at that time the current can be discontinuous. That means the current can be there for some time, it becomes zero, again it starts, then again it is there, again it becomes zero. So this kind of current is called as discontinuous current. So this is prevented because inductor doesn't allow sudden change in current. So this smoothing reactor will allow the current to be constant. Then harmonic filters. Converters generate harmonics. This AC filters are nothing but the harmonic filters. On both the sides actually, we have filter DC and AC filters. So converters generate harmonic and voltages and currents. These harmonics cause overheating of capacitors and nearby generators. So what is the problem due to harmonics? So harmonics cause overheating, okay? They cause interference with telecommunication system and majority of other problems. So that's why we use the harmonic filters to solve this problem, okay? So I hope that you have got some idea about this. Then there are reactive power supplies, like this reactive power supply shown here. What is the use of this reactive power supply? Under steady state condition, reactive power consumed by converter is about 50% of the active power transfer. So if you are transferring 100 megawatt, if you are transferring 100 megawatt, 50 MVAR of the reactive power will be used up, which is a huge value, okay? And under transient conditions, it could be even higher. So therefore, it is provided, we need a reactive power source, okay? This is provided by a shunt capacitor. Okay, that's why a shunt capacitor is shown here, which is used. This shunt capacitor provides the reactive power. Then what is the use of the electrodes? Electrodes are conductors that provide connection to the earth for neutral. So here are the connection to earth from neutral. So these two transformers are connected here and their neutral is earth through electrodes. Okay. They have large surface to minimize the current density and surface voltage gradient. DC lines are, these are the lines. They can be overhead lines or they can be the underground cables. They are very similar to AC lines, nothing special about that. Then the AC circuit breakers, these are the AC circuit breakers, okay? And here as well, AC circuit breakers. They are used to clear the faults in the transformer. And if you want to take out the DC link out of the service, they are not used for clearing the DC faults. So these circuit breakers are on the AC side, they are not on the DC side. So if there is a DC fault, AC circuit breaker is not used. For that we control the converter, okay? So DC faults are cleared by converter control more rapidly. So if you want to clear the DC fault, you have to use the converter control. So rapidly you will reduce the converter angle so that the DC fault can be cleared, all right? So DC faults are in fact more dangerous because they have a large current and continuous current. There is no natural zero. But fortunately, we can control the DC fault current by controlling the firing angle of the bridge rapidly, okay? So these are the components of the converters which you have seen, students. Today we have seen how HVDC converter station looks like. Now from the next class onwards, we are going to see something different. We'll see the converter theory and performance, which is a quite involved thing. It will require a lot of efforts from your side. So we'll go step by step. This is what we want to achieve. Actually, ultimately, we want to study this. We want to study the this six pulse operation and all. Okay. But before directly jumping to this kind of a circuit, we'll have to go through step by step, wherein we'll see a simple rectifier, single diode rectifier. Then we'll slowly keep on adding other terms, and finally, we will arrive at this. All right. So students, I hope that you have got this idea about this particular topic. We'll continue in the next class, okay? So thank you for attending the class and do attempt the attendance quiz.